It's time for the Coach's Corner with the Hall of Fame coach, Tony Grijalva.
Today I'm here with Bernie Luna, the head football coach for the Burgess Mustangs. Coach, how are you this morning?
Pretty good. Thank you.
Good. Let's talk a little bit about, first of all, let's start with the offseason.
Okay? Yes.
You were telling me this year you decided not to have spring ball. How is that different from last year?
A few things is, during our spring game right now, well, last year we had spring football. Mm-hmm. This year we decided not to because, you know what, I just wanted another scrimmage for sure.
Yeah.
So, I think right now our spring camp has gone very well for us. You know, we have about 65 in the class on our average. So the only thing that we did lack is one of our quarterbacks. We have one of the quarterbacks. Mm-hmm. He's been running everything. Our JV quarterback has improved tremendously, so
good.
We're excited about that. And also, I think our bodies got to heal during
this
time.
Yes, of course, yeah. Let me ask you, how do you feel your transition has been from year one last year where you had to do everything,
yeah,
learn everything, and now you're heading into year two, a little bit more experience?
Yeah, I think we're already in the upside for sure because, I already know my style.
Sure.
These coaches already know my style. What is the expectation? What are
right.
the goals? And everybody's stepping up to the challenges.
Great.
So as of right now, everybody has the same goal, mm-hmm. win district. And then the kids understand that, our athletes, and they all believe it right now.
So good.
I think the transition is going pretty well.
Last year, Coach, you made the playoffs, a successful season. Give us a couple of names of individuals that you're going to have to replace.
Just to start off with a quarterback, Alex
sure.
Rios.
Yeah.
He's going to be missed for sure because, he's one of the ones that went through the system.
Right.
As a freshman, just being a quarterback, and then as a sophomore, being a quarterback for mm-hmm. the JV, and then as a junior, being a JV quarterback as well. Mm-hmm. Even though he could have been our backup, but we left him there in the JV just to get the more reps, more experience.
More experience.
And then
right.
as a senior, he only had 1 year of varsity play, and he did well for us.
Yeah.
So he's one of the ones that will be missed. Also, we have Caleb Hanna.
Right.
He's going to be missed because he's a gamer.
Yeah.
And he knew how
good
to score.
Back.
How to run
yeah.
the ball, find the vision. I don't know if we can replace that, but we're gonna be very competitive for sure. Devin Mata,
receiver, right?
We had a lot of weapons, and when you hear our record, 2-9, doesn't make sense, but we just didn't finish.
Right.
But we did have a lot of weapons.
Close games.
Yeah.
Close games.
Evan Lascano as well, mm-hmm. defensively. Caden Evans. We are going to be missing all those guys for sure.
Let's turn our attention now to this year, uh-huh. this coming year. As you said, no spring ball, so you get that extra time in August. Give us a couple of names to look out for.
Oh, for sure. Jaden Bowser, he's going to be one of our slot players and safeties. He's going to be
okay.
going both ways. We got Luke Dexter Quinn as well that's going to be, running the ball for us and playing safety for us
okay.
as well. Who else? Donovan Freeman, he's going to be one of our wideouts far end. We leave him by himself. He's about maybe 5'11", 6 foot,
uh-huh.
and he's very athletic.
Good.
Good. Defensively, we have Cameron Hanna.
Mm-hmm.
He's just more, I consider him one of our shutdown corners, and same thing as Renan Orr. So we do have a lot of experience coming back. We do have a few front linemen that we're expecting to dominate.
Yeah.
Damian Callejas, he's one of our returners, starting for 3 years. Oh, wow. So he has experience. He's a leader. He wants to play in the next level. So,
good.
You know, he's taking that role on. And then we have another, our sophomore is going to be a junior, Julian De Anda. He's a big guy. He's about 6'2".
Oh,
big,
okay.
Great feet. So we're looking to be very competitive.
Good. Let's turn our attention now to the schedule. Your schedule for this coming year. Obviously, you're in a different district, 9-team district, as opposed to a 4-team district the year before. Talk first about your pre-district schedule. I know it's limited.
Yeah. Well, you know, let's just talk about our two scrimmages, right?
Okay.
So let's talk about Isleta. It's our first scrimmage. So it's a good competitive game right there. And then we got East Lake right after that. So it's going to prepare us for, you know, for the first game. And our first game is going to be Bowie, at Bowie. And then our second game is going to be, here for Fabens.
Okay.
And then we start off with Calthea.
Then you start off the rough part. And the most important part, which is district. Tough district that you have there. What do you see as far as goals that you might have to get through district?
You know, it's a mentality. Our goal is to play one game at a time.
Okay.
You know, focus on one game and let's do what we do and let's be very competitive and let's go win. Because, you know, we consider ourselves one of the top four teams in the district.
Right.
So, you know, we have goals, we have expectations, and, you know, our athletes understand the importance.
Mm-hmm.
Our coaches know the importance. And we're taking things around, the culture. And, you know, we're trying to be a little bit tougher, and we are so far. I've been seeing growth all over the program. So
That's a great sign.
Yeah, that's definitely a great sign.
Yeah. Coach, thank you for your time. We look forward to seeing you during the season, and good luck to you.
All right. Thank you, guys.
Thank you for watching. Visit us at epsportsnetwork.com for your source of sports and entertainment.